What's going on? I don't know where to put this. It's Wednesday. Last night, we got confirmation for an interview in Iceland for Thor. And we're leaving tomorrow. So, I'm in a rush to get ready and get sorted. Flights were booked last night, got to get the gear ready. I have zero winter clothes and we're going to Iceland and it's cold out there. So I need to get winter clothes today. We just went to Lidl's, got some nice Lidl's t-shirts, some nice little jackets, dead cheap. Nice and warm.
We are driving on the way to Luton Airport to go to Iceland.
Oh, it would probably said that about five times. Did you spill it?
It's hot. It's just hot.
So yeah, we're off to meet Thor. We're going to the power gym to see them train. And then we've got one day free in Iceland and it's raining. On the way to London. When interviews are involved, it's really stressful because obviously there's a lot hanging on getting there. When you're going on holiday, obviously it's annoying if you miss your flight. Because we're on tight schedules with a lot of these interviews and these people can only do certain dates. If we miss the dates, we miss the interview, we lose the interview. So that's why they're a bit more stressful. But yeah, we're off to Iceland now. We just got through security. That's always the worst part when you've got camera gear. If you're carrying batteries and camera gear and stuff, they're gonna stop you for security. Don't get arsy about it. Just keep it chilled out. We're in Iceland. Where? That man there is Jonathon Ross. But we're not gonna bother him. We've got work to do, so let's crack on. There you go, Jonathon Ross in Iceland. You ready, Will? The next thing I would recommend when flying abroad and doing camera stuff, always hire a car, it's cheap as chips. No more transfers, it's useful. Yeah, and for filming it's the best. We had an extra few kilos in the baggage allowance, like 5 or 6 kilos, so we'll fill it with food. It's supposed to be quite expensive in Iceland, so this is how we're doing it on a budget. Is the chef gone now?
Yeah, so we had an Icelandic chef.
We've got a big kitchen there.
Moving really fast. We was just with Jonathon Ross, I'll probably put that clip
in. Oh yeah, we'll put the Jonathon Ross clip in. Interview tomorrow, we're going to prepare some questions. We've got a Tesla to try and buy tonight, but we're more about getting the equipment sorted. We don't actually know what to expect. This was done on a day's notice.
Will's on the big weights today. Lifting heavy.
Okay guys, sorry about the cringe. Whilst I was here, the Tesla Cybertruck last night was unveiled and we saw it. Now, we don't know what's going on. It's a strange looking truck. I think I'll grow to love it, but right now I'm a bit like that. But the specs, the price, everything about it, it's a utility vehicle and for filmmaking, it's gonna be really ideal having those power outlets and having a moving set. I mean, I don't know what to think of it. Okay, so we've just ordered the Cybertruck. We pre-ordered the top spec one. One of the main things that we're ordering these trucks for, hopefully we're getting more than one, but the main reason is so we can have, it'll be our rig car, so we can actually use it for filming, we can drive it for filming, we can set locations up and sets up. All of our lights that we're purchasing at the moment are LED lights, like Anova lights and Aria doing a good LED series. So they should all be able to run off the truck.
Right, we just packed up the car, we've ordered gear, and we are driving to Thor's gym right now. Bye.
So we're in Thor's gym, and we've just finished up filming them guys train. We're just setting the interview up now, just setting the lighting up. Here he comes anyway, so we've got to set this up.
And the hardest thing is there's nothing I can do. Sometimes you're put into difficult positions, and that's life. it's not easy.
So we're just about to head to the Black Beach and film some drone shots, and it's extremely windy, but we'll give it a go. Hey! Oh, look behind you. That's what I just want you to pull the camera out soon, because the sun sets really early around here.
Good morning. Will and Jordan here. We're on a beach, but come over here, they've got some funny shaped rocks.
We've just been to the lava tunnel. How much lava have we seen, George?
Zero. Do not go.
No lava.
Okay, so we are supposedly at a glacier. I cannot see one. We've got the cameras. See if we can get some photography. The drone has now run out, so I won't be able to do a drone of the glacier, which is really upsetting. I feel like crying.
You did cry when the camera
was on. I cried. So we're at the glacier, and yeah, we've got some really cool shots already. The idea is you can't really see scale for an iPhone, and that's what we're trying to do. We've got a nice long lens on, so trying to show you like, well, trying on the footage, trying to show how tiny the humans are who are walking up it, so we can gauge scale of how massive it is. It's just ridiculously big. Okay, so right up here, there's some people walking up, so that's good scale. Got some more footage, who knows.
It's always better than nothing.
So we're on the way back now from, we went to the Black Beach, we went to the
Glacier.
Went to the waterfalls, and we're now heading back to the apartment. We're gonna get a workout done. We're on a deload day, so I'm doing chest. So we're gonna get back. We've got to pack up tonight. We've got to check in to the apartment, to the flights. Well, you gotta remind me to do that shit. And then we're flying back tomorrow. Back tomorrow. That's it.
On footage, and we realised that the A cam, I'd say about 70% of it is cropped and won't work, so that's a bit annoying. We get home, try to fix it, we can't. Ring up Red, they say there's nothing you can do about it. Try Red Undead, we tried Red Undead, didn't work. And then we decided to send it off to Junimag, and they rang us back. They says we shouldn't have tried Red Undead because it ruins it.
Okay, so we just got an update from Junimag, which is a UK company who do data recovery on Red Mags, and they've just said they recovered all the footage. One mistake we made was running check disk, and we tried to fix it ourselves. I think in future, if you ever lose footage, we're not going to do anything, probably just send it straight to a company because they've managed to save it. But they did say some damage is done with all the. We ran Red Undead a few times because Red told us to, so we won't be doing that again in future. We ran Windows check this because someone told us to. We're doing that again in the future. But they've managed to get it all back, and now they're just asking about a hard drive. So yeah, really good news. And that looks like the footage.
Sweet, I'm happy about that.
Sorry, man.
So we haven't been able to put ACAM in yet, but once we've got ACAM, the video is ready. We just need to relink it all and colour grade ACAM. And then we will have a finished product, which should be out hopefully. I want to get it out tomorrow or day after, but we still don't have the delivery, so we're still waiting on Ginny Mag.
Our parcels arrive, Will.
Is the red mag inside here?
Yes. They've done a good job Ginny there.
Yeah, I didn't send it this wall pack for them. This is Ginny Mag. Is it our original red mag? It is! Yeah. I know it is because it's got the same marks on. That is our red mag. So there you go. So Ginny Mag, are they worth using? Well, they recovered all our lost footage for £100 and sent it back recorded, signed for, with UPS tracking.
That's what we know so far.
So it's been proxying for quite a while now, so I'm just going to do a workout where I start proxies. So this is the timeline, all finished, and it is like Jordan says, Luke don't care, but Jordan says we edit too messy, because it's just all scattered. So I'm just rendering it again because I rendered it and there was a mistake, so I watched it back and there was a mistake. Yeah, this is the sort of stuff that just takes a while because, I don't know, maybe I'm getting the settings wrong. And there's just sometimes little mistakes here and there. I'm out of breath because I've just been doing deadlifts. But I sent the video to Runa and Thor. Runa got back, said it was amazing, gave him goosebumps. That's always a good sign. Goosebumps is my number one sign of how good a video is normally. And what we do, I hate posting because I always feel like I've made a mistake. But I've put all the description. Normally this stuff takes really long because you're messing about with names. And then all you do, like that, click public, done, and then you have to save changes.